My mom is standing there, screaming at the top of her lungs. You'll kill Grandpa if you tell him. He deserves to know. That's what I think, but I don't know anymore.
Well, it must feel awful being stuck in the middle, but that's where you are.
Either way I go, somebody gets hurt.
Well, you know what you have to do.
Yeah, I'm just nowhere near ready to do it.
Hypothetically, if I told you there's this really cute guy waiting for you in the courtyard, who would you want it to be?
If it could be anybody?
I'll narrow it down for you. Right. Matt or Dylan?
Okay, there's nothing going on between me and Dylan.
Oh, okay. Then your answer is Matt. Or not.
So you ready to be taken away from all your troubles?
That depends. You ready to listen to them?
Okay. All right. So, we'll start with Brandon.
Brandon. Brandon and I were best friends, but we didn't swing from chandeliers. What?
Oh, nothing. It's just, well... You and I have been a lot of things to each other over the years, Kel. Never best friends. Now, as far as chandeliers go...
I have a vague recollection.
Yeah. So what you're saying is that somehow I came between you two.
No, that's not what I'm saying.
Isn't it?
No. I mean, not exactly.
What do you mean?
You know, this has nothing to do with you.
You missed what we had.
No. What we had was missing from what I had with Brandon.
You missed that?
Yes.
Good. Now that we got that figured out.
So you still haven't told me why you're back.
I sold the house. So I'll be staying at the Peninsula. Why don't you come by and we'll have dinner?
Your being here scares me.
Why?
I hadn't planned on it.